This is Math 99. We are doing section 12.6, and we're just doing more work with exponential equations. Do a little bit with what's called the change of base formula. So first off, let me deal with something like this: log base 7 of 500. Now, last time I showed you that we had a log button, but it's only a log base 10 button. It's not a log base 7 button. Oh yeah, we also have a natural log button. But that's a log base e. That doesn't help us directly with this log base 7. So what I want to do right now is show you a way to solve this, but it's going to lead to a general equation that we can use. So this first part, I'm just kind of demonstrating a way that we could go about solving this, but it's going to lead to a formula that's going to be a lot less work. So log base 7 of 500. I want to know what that's equal to, so I'm going to say it's equal to x. So I'll rewrite this as 7 to the x equals 500, right? Because this is asking 7 to what power would give me 500. So I have that. So now what I'm going to do, I don't have a log base 7 button, but I do have a log base 10 button. So I'm going to think of 7 in terms of 10 to some power. Like if I could figure out what that is, right? I could just go log of 7. So to me right now, 7 is just going to be 10 to some power. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to place this 7, that 10 to the y, since they're equal to each other. So I have 10 to the y to the x equals 500. All right. Boy, it makes it look worse, doesn't it? A power to a power is multiplication. So this is 10 to the power of x times y equals 500. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to kick this back into a logarithm. So base 10 is just log, right? Like log base 10 is just log. And the reason I chose that is because I have that button. So now I could rewrite this as log base 10 of 500 equals the exponent. Remember, logarithms spit out exponents. So I just rewrote this from exponential form to logarithmic form. So now I have x times y equals log 500. Well, at least I could do that part of my calculator. That's pretty good. So now let me think about what y is, because I'm trying to find x. I'm solving for x. Let me think about what y is. Oh, yeah, I made that up. So y is the exponent of 10 to that power equals 7. So I could rewrite this as y equals log base 10 of 7. Yeah, 10's my base. Log base 10 of 7 is the exponent. So y is equal to this. So what I can do with this is put this into the y spot. So now I have x times, what was y? Log 7, log of 7 equals log of 500. And let's see, log of 500 is just a number. Log of 7 is just a number. So if I want to get x all alone, I can divide both sides by that log of 7. And I get x equals log of 500 over log of 7. Which I can do that on my calculator because I have a log base 10 button. So log 500 divided by log 7. About 3.194. Interesting. So notice what I'm claiming is 7 to the power of 3.194 is 500. Well, about 500 because I rounded that. So let's try that. 7 to the power of 3.194. A little more than 500. That makes sense to me because I rounded up, right? That was a 3 and I rounded up. So that's pretty powerful. Now I can manipulate this to get it into a form that I can do my calculator. You know, all that work, I started with this, log base 7 of 500, and I did this manipulation, and I ended up with this, equals log 500 divided by log 7. So notice that base 10, I chose the 10, and I chose that because I had that button. But I could have chosen anything. Like I could have chosen this to be a log 8, which actually doesn't help me at all, but I could have done it. I could have chosen a base E. I noticed that would have given me natural log of 500 divided by natural log of 7. And it's really interesting. That gives me the same answer. So natural log of 500 divided by natural log of 7. Oh, I forgot to close off the parentheses. No, I put them in the wrong spot. 500, close off the parentheses, divided by natural log of 7. There's that 3.19, blah, blah, blah. Same thing. And actually, like, no matter what my base is, all those values are the same. But if I'm going to do this so I can use my calculator, I'm going to choose either E or 10 as my base because those are the buttons I have. Now, this I think is super clever. And I want to add something to it. What we did is we changed the base. In other words, this was in base 7. We did this manipulation and we changed it to it was two things in base 10, or base E if we wanted, or base whatever that we wanted. But I did it specifically. I did it for 7 and 500. But what I want to point out here is I could have done it just for like A and B. And notice that 7 is my A, B is my 500. Everything would be the same. And what I would end up with would be log of B over log of A. So what I'm saying is if I have log base A of B, I can rewrite it as log whatever, like, because I brought it in, it's not connected to the A and B, of B over log whatever, that same whatever of A. There's some nice symmetry up here, right? Notice that the large, the this regular script goes to the top, the subscript goes to the bottom part. What we're doing is we're changing, it's the change of base formula, and what we're doing is we're changing the base from one thing to another thing, but it's one from a single log statement to two log statements. They're divided by each other. That's my change of base formula. And I'm going to use it now. So I'm going to erase. All right, here we go. Let's deal with something like log base 3 of 12. I want to evaluate that. I want to see what that's equal to. Now I could go through all the big steps I went through before, but I know where they're going to end up. That's what the change of base formula tells me. So it's log base 3 of 12. That's the same as log whatever I want. I'm going to choose base 10 of 12 divided by log same base of 3. I can do that on my calculator. So log 12. Sorry. Close off the parentheses. Divided by log 3. I get about 2.2619. And notice what I'm saying when I say this. I'm saying 3 to that power will equal 12. And since I hadn't happed around it, it's not exactly equal to 12. It's about 12. So it's a little flaky equal sign. So let me check it. These are really easy to check on my calculator. 3 to the power of 2.262. I guess I'm really close to 12, so I know that I'm right. Let's do another one. If I had to find something like log base 6 of 180, I'm just going to use that change of base formula. Now I used log base 10 last time, and you can always use log base 10. I'm just going to use natural log this time just to show that you could use it as well. Natural log, natural log. So 180, so natural log of 180 divided by natural log of 6. Get on my calculator with that. Natural log of 180, close off the parentheses, divided by natural log of 6. About 2.898. I think that's what it was. Let me check. And again, if I, you know, if I don't trust it, I'll just go six to that power. Pretty close to 180, and I round it, so yeah, for sure. Great. So once I have a log, I can use the change of base to evaluate it and use my calculator. You know, pre-calculator, this was something that someone would have had to do by using lookup tables. They actually carried books around where they could look up these values. So let's use this new change of base formula that we have to solve some equations. So for example, if I had 5 to the x equals 30. So first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to change it. So it's in exponential form. I'm going to rewrite it in log form. So that would be log base 5 of 30 equals x. So x is equal to that. But I know that this log base 5 of 30, I can use that change of base form. That would be, I could use natural log or I could use log base 10. I mean, the common log, I'm going to use natural log. Natural log of 30 over natural log of 5, right? The subscript goes to the bottom, top goes to the top. So x is equal to that. So natural log of 30 divided by natural log of 5. Just shove that into my calculator. I mean, sorry, put it into my calculator. Natural log of 30 divided by natural log of 5. It looks like that's about 2.113. Yeah. And it's easy to check. I just go 5 to the power of that, and it should be close to 30. And it is. So, how about another one? What if I had 8 to the negative x? I meant that to be an x. Is equal to 17. Well, let's see. First thing I'm going to do is rewrite it as a log statement. So, log base 8 of 17 is the exponent. The exponent here is a negative x. So, let me rewrite this with that change of base formula. Log base 8 is 17. I'm going to use log this time. And my choices are arbitrary. I'm just trying to demonstrate you can use log or natural log, and they both give me answers. Equals negative x. So log 17 divided by log 8. Again, I'm going to go over to my calculator. About 1.362. But notice that's equal to negative x. So if I want to know what x is, multiply both sides by negative 1. X is, and it's about since I rounded, negative 1.362. Great. Let's do another example. How about 9 to the power of x plus 1 equals 3? Oh, this is interesting. So notice I have a base to some power equals some number. So I'm just going to rewrite it as a log statement first. Log base 9 of 3 is equal to the exponent, and the exponent is an x plus 1. So this log base 9 of 3, I can change that using that change of base formula. And after I do, you get x, I'm going to have to subtract 1 from it. So I'm just going to subtract 1 from both sides first, and then I'll just write this as negative 1 plus log base 9 of 3. That's equal to x. So let me put that in. Oh, and at that log base 9 of 3, I'm going to rewrite that using change of base formula. So negative 1 plus log of the standard script over log of the subscript. So log base 3 divided by log base 9. So I had negative 1 plus log of 3 divided by log of 9. Negative 1 half. Well, that's interesting. Wow. So what that's saying is if I plug negative 1 half into here, 9 to that power will equal 3. Let me try that. I'm going to go 9 to the power of negative 1 half plus 1. I'll just do it on my calculator. 9 to the power of negative 1 half plus 1 is 3. Great. I do love that these are easy to check on your calculator. All right, let's do another one. 2 to the power of 2x plus 1 equals 30. So notice I have 2 to some power, to some exponent, equals 30. So let me rewrite this as a log statement first. Log base 2 of 30 is 2x plus 1. Now this log base 2 of 30, that's just a number. I can evaluate it with that change of base formula. So I'm going to write it as natural log of 30 over natural log of 2, and that equals 2x plus 1. So like I just said, this is just a number. So if I want to get x, I can subtract 1 from both sides and divide by 2, or multiply by half, same thing. So I'm going to end up subtracting 1 from both sides. So then over here it, you know, cancels out. And then I'm going to multiply both sides by a half, or divide the whole thing by 2, same thing. But basically what I'm going to have is 1 half of negative 1 plus natural log of 30 divided by natural log of 2. And that should give me an x value. So let me see if I can't throw that into my calculator and see what I get. So 1 half, and I like to do it just in one big entry in the calculator. If you want to do it a piece at a time, that is perfectly fine. Negative 1 plus natural log of 30 divided by natural log of 2. And I get about 1.953. Now, that could be kind of tricky to see if that's actually what the answer is or not. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to check this on my calculator. And my equation is this 2 to the power of 2x plus 1 equals 30. One thing I can do on this calculator is I could type this 1.953 back in. But since it's the last answer that I got, on my calculator I have this little answer button. It's second and then the minus, the negative sign. So I'm going to do it this way. I'm going to go 2 to the power of, and then parentheses, it's 2x plus 1. So 2 times the answer I got plus 1. And it should give me a 30. Yeah, so I know that I'm right. Another example, one more like this. 7 to the power of 4x plus 3 equals 200. All right, I have something to a power equals something, so there's my exponent. I'm going to rewrite this as a log statement. So it would be log base 7 of 200 equals 4x plus 3. Now this log base 7 of 200, that's just a number. I know I can evaluate it with that change of base formula, log 200 divided by log 7. And then once I know that number, I would subtract 3 and divide by 4. Or multiply by 4 to get the answer. So I'd subtract 3 from both sides, and then I would divide the whole thing by 4. So what I'm going to end up with is a fourth of negative 3 plus log 200 divided by log 7. And again, if you want to do that one piece at a time in your calculator, then do it that way. You know, I just like to I prefer to enter it all in one big entry. But you could, you know, do this on your calculator, then subtract 3, then divide by 4. Just make sure that you're doing your order of operations right. So I've got 1 fourth times negative 3 plus log 200. Close off those parentheses, divided by log 7. And I get about that number, negative 0.069. So according to this, x is about negative 0.069. Let me check it, right? Because it's 7 to the power of 4x plus 3. So if I go 7 to the power of, and this is going to be in parentheses, this part, 4, and I want to use the last answer that I got, plus 3. Yeah, plus 3 should give me 200. Yeah, I know my answer is right. So we are going to start with some money, $5,000, and we're going to invest it at 3% compounded continuously. Now we don't know how long we're going to let this sit here for, so but we do want to know how long it will take to double. That's kind of a common investment question. How long will it take this money, this growth rate, to double? So let's write what we do know. We know that this is compounding continuously, so it's a PERT formula. We started at $5,000. We're getting 3%. We don't know the amount of time. What we do want to know is how long it takes to double. So $5,000 would grow up to $10,000. So we want to solve this. Let's solve this. And in solving this, what I want to do is get this e all alone and then solve this probably with natural log under z. So first thing I'm going to do is notice it's 5,000 times that. Divide that by 5,000. So I'm here. So now my next step is to I'm going to rewrite this. This is e to some power is 2. So that means that the natural log of 2 must be the exponent. Divide by 0.03. So t is the natural log of 2 over 0.03. Notice natural log of how much I want it to grow divided by the rate. So clear this off. Natural log of 2, close that, divided by the rate. So according to this, it would take about 23 years, a little more than 23. So I'll say 23.1. So, that much money in these conditions would take about that long to double. Kind of interesting. Let's try it with a different amount. So, instead of $5,000, what if it was $20? $20 at 3% compounding continuously, how long to double? So, notice our setup would be this would be 20 and this would be 40. And then we would divide both sides by 20 to get rid of that 20. And we'd end up here again. This is a question about the rate, about how fast it's taking, right? Like how fast it goes would dictate how long. The amount I start with doesn't matter. I could start with $1, I could start with $1 million. Given these conditions, it will always take that amount of time to double. And for this one, let's just start with $100. And we'll keep it at 3%, but instead of compounding continuously, I'm going to have it compound quarterly. How long to double? So quarterly, that's a different formula, right? So that formula would be my principal, one plus the rate divided by the number of compoundings to the power of the number of compoundings times the time. I don't know the time, and I want to know how long that will take to double. Now, some of you might have been clever and just written this just as a 2 and nothing here, like a 1 here, because as you know, our first step is going to be to divide by 100. So, how long to double? You know, if we were asking how long to triple, that would be a 3, quadruple, that would be a 4, etc. The amount of money we start with doesn't really matter. So let's go from here. Now, this is kind of a mess, but it's interesting because we have some base to a power equals 2. So if I rewrite this as a log statement, it's going to be log base this. This is my base, the whole thing. So 1 plus 0.03 divided by 4 of 2 would give me the exponent. So let me keep going from here. I know that this log base whatever of 2, I could rewrite that using the change of base formula. So I'm going to think of this as natural log of 2 divided by natural log of 1 plus 0.03 over 4. And if I wanted, you know, solve for t, I could take a fourth of this, multiply this whole thing by a fourth. So I have 1/4 times natural log of 2 over natural log of 1 plus 0.03 over 4. And that should give me the time. So I want to enter that into my calculator. It's a lot to put in. You can do it a piece at a time. I like to do it all at once. 1/4 times the natural log of 2 divided by natural log of 1 plus 0.03 divided by 4. And I get 23.19. And notice it takes a little more time than last time. But I would expect it to take longer because quarterly doesn't grow as fast as continuous. All right, give these problems a go. You got a lot of practice to do on these ones, but I try to give a little extra time on them. Good luck. Send me questions.